Fort Lewis, Washington, March 21st, 1987. Jonathan Creon Stewart is welcomed to this planet like the rest of us, as an unknown child, just one of millions born every day. Except this baby will one day be the face of a young NFL franchise for nearly a decade. His impact on the team is monumental, and his name is in the top of the Carolina Panthers record books. This is the story of the best running back in Panthers history. As a freshman in high school, Stewart was already marked for greatness. He rushed for 1,279 rushing yards and 15 touchdowns and 95 carries as he set the tone on how the rest of his Blazers career would go. After his 4 years, he collected 7,755 yards and 105 touchdowns, as well as collecting USA Today's All-American honors, Washington Gatorade Player of the Year, and a school record in the 100-meter dash with a time of 10.78 seconds. As a five-star recruit, Jonathan had some tough choices to make when deciding where to commit to, with Notre Dame, Washington State, USC, Tennessee, Ohio State, Nebraska, and Cal all fighting for the 10th best player in the nation to join their schools, only to be turned down. Eventually, the number one running back in the country committed to the University of Oregon. Similar to high school, Stewart started off hot in Eugene. Returning kicks, he was able to get two special team touchdowns and led the nation in average yards gained on kickoffs. He was able to finish his freshman year with 9 total touchdowns on 72 touches. Real quick side note, just to show how naturally ready Stewart was to play the next level, in his freshman year, in his first game ever, he goes totally beast mode here and just disregards defenders until 5 guys had to jump on him. As a college sophomore who has like similar height and weight and around the same age as Stewart was then, I think I have the authority to say, holy f***. With more of a role on the offense his sophomore year, he played in 13 games, rushing for 981 yards as compared to his 188 from the season previous. Scoring 10 rushing touchdowns and adding 1 receiving set Stewart up to succeed in his junior season for the Ducks. With the offense looking to move lightning fast, Stewart looked to establish himself as one of the nation's top backs. He proceeded to rush for 1,722 yards and 13 total touchdowns. His highlight of that season was a 251-yard, 2-touchdown game he put up against my Washington Huskies. Thanks a lot, John. After beating USF in the Sun Bowl 56-21, Stewart declared for the NFL draft, looking to gain more success as he had in both college and high school before it. As the second running back taken in the first round at 13th overall to Carolina Panthers, high expectations were heaped onto the 21-year-old from Fort Lewis. The Panthers were coming off an injury-filled 7-9 season and already had 2006 27th overall running back D'Angelo Williams on the roster. Despite this, Stewart was seen as the option to fit head coach John Fox's scheme better, and the word coming out of camp was he was to start, with Williams being a change of pace back for the upcoming season. Instead, Williams put on a 1,515-yard year with 18 rushing touchdowns. Now, Stewart wasn't a slouch either, as he amassed 836 yards and 10 rushing scores in a backup role, as the Panthers reached 12-4, good enough for second best in the conference, but lost the divisional round to the Arizona Cardinals. To give you a taste of like what he really had in store for the league, on his first ever Monday Night Football game, he took a handoff to the right, met one-on-one with Rondé Barber, and stiff-armed him into another freaking dimension. Going into the 2009 season, the expectations for the Panthers were high, as they were coming off a franchise-best record and were looking to repeat as NFC South champions. But as the Panthers fans who are probably watching this already know, that didn't happen, as they fell to 8-8 and missed the playoffs altogether. But this was in no fault to the running back tandem. Opposed to the season prior, where Williams received nearly 90 more carries, both Stewart and D'Angelo split the touches right down the middle, making an incredible 1-2 punch that was able to produce in a big way. They were just the 6th team in NFL history to have 2 1,000-yard rushers on the team in the same season, and first ever to have both over 1,100 yards. The highlight of that season was when Stewart completely teabags the entire Giants defense by running headfirst into a dogpile, somehow escaping, outrunning men who are 20 pounds lighter than him only to be stopped by an ankle tackle at the 1-yard line. Unfortunately, this would be his career high mark, as the next year Williams missed 10 games as Stewart was forced to take the brunt of the workload. With that, Jonathan also missed time, and in the 14 games he did play, he was only able to rack up 770 yards and 2 touchdowns. The Panthers went an abysmal 2-14, head coach John Fox was fired, and with the number one pick in the 2011 draft, the Panthers selected quarterback Cam Newton from Auburn. Ahead of the 2012 season, Stewart was given a contract for 5 years, $36.5 million, to make sure he would stay in Carolina's future plans and give their new quarterback a reliable running back to help him steer the ship on offense. Despite both Williams and Stewart back to full health, they both had trouble recapturing their 2009 forms. Stewart's numbers continued to fall as he had 761 yards and 4 touchdowns. Now, this may be the change in coach or play calling, or maybe the giant rookie quarterback taking his touches, rushing for 706 yards and 14 touchdowns of his own on the way to his first Pro Bowl. Who's to say? Unfortunately for Stewart, the next season he was only able to stay healthy for 9 games as he dealt with several ankle and foot related injuries. Due to his loss of play time, he would put out a season of only 336 yards. This would be his lowest yard mark in his career up to this point, only to be outdone by his 2013 campaign, where he collected 180 yards in 6 games played, after missing games early in the season due to the prior ankle injuries. But after he returned, he went back on IR due to a torn MCL against New Orleans Saints in Week 14. All these injuries started to weigh on Stewart, as the term injury prone began to float around, but he wasn't one to sit back and allow narratives like these to cast a shadow on him as a player. He worked hard that offseason, telling the Charlotte Observer he started doing yoga as an alternative workout to help prevent injuries. He was ready for the 2014 season to start and reestablish himself as one of the top backs in football, until he tweaked a hamstring that August and had to sit out most of training camp. And then, because football is the greatest anti-knee establishment in America, he sprained his previously torn MCL and missed weeks 4, 5, and 6. However, he was still able to come back and play and put up respectable numbers, and even played well in the Panthers' 2 playoff games. Stewart's longtime running mate D'Angelo Williams would depart from Charlotte following the season to the greener pastures of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. 2015 was finally returned to the Jonathan Stewart of old, as in the 13 games he played, he recorded 989 yards and 6 touchdowns. But apparently John must have been cursed by an old hag, as he was yet again knocked out of the final 3 games of the regular season, with yet another sprained foot. But this wouldn't be the season-killing injuries of old, as his team ended up going 15-1, allowing Stewart to get an extra bye week the rest of his foot and come to play in the team's playoff games healthy. In his first games back, he put up over 100 yards on the ground and a pair of touchdowns to help the Panthers move past the Seahawks, and then next week he did what he had to do as Cam Newton took over and pushed him right past the Cardinals and onto the Super Bowl. Despite Stewart diving over a wall of men at the goal line like Free Willy, they didn't come away with the Lombardi. However, Stewart got to enjoy his first and only Pro Bowl and All-Pro appearance. Full of confidence heading into the next season, he was able to generally repeat his success with 825 rushing yards and 9 touchdowns, in only 13 games of course, as in this point of his career, missing 3 games every season it kind of became a tradition, and his hamstrings decided to celebrate this season. Despite the decent numbers, his yards per attempt had dropped down to 3.8, which is decent if not below average, but something even more disastrous would happen that season that would forever change Stewart's career. The Panthers sucked. At a measly 6-10, 1 year after going 15-1, finishing 4th in the division, the Panthers obtained the 8th overall pick and a new face of the offense. With the pick they took, Stanford superstar running back Christian McCaffrey. On the surface, this looked to be another D'Angelo Williams to complement Stewart. But McCaffrey soon was able to break out and establish himself as an every down back and is now the best running back in the NFL. Don't at me. Ahead of the 2017-18 season, Stewart inked a 1-year contract that looked as though it was the last deal he'd have with the team. The emergence of his new co-star cut Stewart's workload down. He took 20 less carries than the year before and only missed 1 game because his back decided it wanted the injury spotlight in warmups of Week 17. He was back for Wildcard Weekend, just in time to be bounced by New Orleans Saints, only for them to get their hearts broken by a certain miracle. This season spelled the end for Stewart and Charlotte, as he rushed for 680 yards, and McCaffrey looked to take over starting duties while accumulating 1,086 yards from scrimmage his rookie year. The Panthers released him that offseason, and for the first time in his career, Stewart would be playing outside of Carolina. After visits with the Seahawks and Lions, Stewart landed a deal with the New York Giants for 2 years, $6.8 million. He was viewed as taking on a mentor role for second overall pick Saquon Barkley as he slipped further past his prime. In weeks 1 through 3, Stewart attempted 6 carries for 17 yards before his feet attempted to retire without him, and he was placed on IR with an undisclosed foot injury and eventually released the following offseason. In 2019, after getting no real offers of free agency, Stewart signed a 1-day contract and retired as a Panther. In the end, he racked up the most rushing yards by any Panthers running back with 7,318 and second most rushing touchdowns with 51, only 7 behind his quarterback Cam Newton. Stewart is one of the best running backs in Panthers history, and he is still doing charity work in the city of Charlotte to this day. Quote, "This game has given me a lot. This place taught me what it means to be professional and to have the right priorities. Even in such a production-based business, that's what makes Carolina so special. Being a Carolina Panther prepared me for the rest of my life. That's how I see it." Thank you guys so much for listening to this episode of Carearview Mirror on Jonathan Stewart. To hit subscribe, hit that logo right there on the screen, and we picked out a video right to the right of it. And I'll see you next time.